Good morning, Cedar Park. Today is Friday, March 31st, 2023, and it's a B-Day.
This morning, get the rundown on Theater's UIL One Act Play, The Children's Hour.
Your Friday sports report as we prepare for Texas Relays and Round 3 of playoffs for boys soccer.
Plus, Kira Cox has your headlines on this in This Morning on The Brief. Get lit because the Wolfcast starts now. Good morning, Cedar Park, and welcome back. I'm Abby Martinez, and I'm here this morning with Jack Polishek and Katie Whitmarsh.
Earlier this month, the theater program here at Cedar Park participated in their annual UIL One Act Play competition.
They performed a show called The Children's Hour, a play centered around a student spreading lies about their school's teachers, leading towards many consequences. Let's throw it over to birthday boy Anthony Luparello with more.
Thanks, Katie. After a successful district performance with their comedy-oriented play, Sweet Surrender, last spring, Thespian Troupe 6289 returned to the stage to compete in this year's UIL One Act Play competition with their production, The Children's Hour.
Light shining upon the glaring stage, set pieces stacked atop one another, and actors articulating their lines in front of the audience. These are some of the many aspects that theater put into their production of The Children's Hour, a drama by Lillian Hellman that stars Claire Poulter and Braille Swift as two school teachers named Karen Wright and Martha Dobie that work at a private boarding school that, when falsely rumored to be dating one another, results in a lot of emotional turmoil for the two.
I knew I wanted Martha from the moment I read it because she has a story that, because the main theme of the play is that, you know, lying isn't good. It can ruin things that are beautiful and all that stuff. But Martha has a specific story that I feel like a lot of people in history can relate to. And I wanted to give her justice and give them justice and tell her story.
Acting since middle school, Brielle Swift has been into theater for quite a while, landing many notable roles throughout both her middle and high school acting career, such as Joy in the Yellow Boat and Claudia McFadden in Sweet Surrender.
To me, it means telling someone else's story. You know, I never see acting as lying. I see it as like living someone else's truth. And so it's really fun having the opportunity to do that, especially like if you understand a character and to do it well. Like, that's awesome. That's all I could ever want to do, is to make it believable and tell someone's story.
However, around a week before their first public performance, guidelines within the publishing company of The Children's Hour had forced the thespians to cut out the first two acts of the show, causing a number of characters to be removed from the show, thereby making some roles much more crucial to the plot. This is what happened to senior Ben McDonald's character, Dr. Joseph Carden.
We go on a retreat every year the weekend before competition to like run the show and kind of do some team building. And normally it's about like finalizing it and getting it like really like fine-tuned and perfect. But this year we spent a lot of time just like doing the basics just because we had to relearn everything. And so it was really rough at first. I think we were all discouraged in the very beginning, but it got a lot better and we took a lot of time off. It's a lot of veterans who've done this before. And so if this were to happen any year, this is the year for it. And we'll bounce back and it's gonna be good.
The cast and crew of The Children's Hour performed in the Zone competition on March 2nd at Ross High School and placed 4th, with Brielle Swift receiving an award for Best Performer and Ben McDonald for All-Star Cast.
There is an element of luck there with the judges, just, you know, what they're looking for, what their personal opinions are. And so you can't you should respect the results and, you know, they're not choosing these things randomly, but there is an element of luck and you can't read too much into their decision and base your value off of what someone else thinks of you.
This play is really special to me, not just because of the character I got, but because of the cast and how most of it is seniors that started everything for me. And I'm very lucky and honored to act with these people.
Make sure to go out and congratulate the cast and crew of The Children's Hour for going out and putting on quite the show.
Thanks, Anthony. Coming up, Kira Cox has today's headlines, including the latest on former President Trump's indictment. But first, these announcements.
Good morning, Cedar Park, and welcome to this morning's brief. First, former President Donald Trump was indicted by the Manhattan grand jury yesterday for more than 30 counts related to business fraud. The former president is being charged in connection with a hush money payment to adult film star Stormy Daniels made by his former lawyer, Michael Cohen. Trump's attorney states that Trump will likely be arraigned early next week. Next, a Wall Street Journal reporter is being detained in Russia for accusations of spying on state secrets. Reporter Evan Gershkovic faces up to 20 years in prison. The Wall Street Journal is concerned for the safety of Gershkovic and denies the allegations and is demanding his immediate release. Finally, Gwyneth Paltrow won a countersuit for a single dollar after the retired optimist Terry Sanderson sued her for a skiing collision in Colorado 7 years ago. According to Sanderson, the collision resulted in over $300,000 worth of physical and emotional damage and was suing Paltrow for $3.2 million. Paltrow argued that Sanderson caused the collision rather than the other way around and that the jury returned their verdict in 2 hours. So, what do we think?
I think it's super powerful that she did it for a dollar because she doesn't need the money. Like, she's not gonna drain this guy of his bank account. She just wants to make a statement, which I think is really, it's way more powerful than getting $1 million or something like that.
I just wanna see that check that's just like $1. Yeah.
Was it cash? Like
60 cents? Here's a dollar bill.
4 quarters, like.
I'm just excited for the Goop Lab season 2. Oh.
Okay.
That's her show. That's her Netflix.
Okay.
That's her,
well.
Yeah. It's a really interesting, cool show.
Wow. Well, thanks, Kira. Coming up, Weekend Destinations with Reagan Hill right after this break.
Good morning, Cedar Park. I'm Reagan Hill here with your weekend destinations. First up, join the Spring Mini Market this Sunday, April 2nd from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. You'll be able to browse over 55 woman-owned businesses, including accessories, beauty, food, home goods, and more. The mini market is free to attend and family-friendly. If you're interested, you can find more information on eventbrite.com. Next, visit the Latin America Market happening every first Sunday of the month. This Latino market takes place at the Sentinel Plaza in Round Rock. You'll be able to experience the lively community of locals, visitors, families, and artists. If you're interested, visit LatinaAmericaMarket.com. Lastly, visit the 2023 ABC Kite Fest for the 95th anniversary at Zilker Park. The festival will be going on this Sunday, April 1st from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. and it will be free for you all to attend. The Kite Festival brings Austinites together where you can fly colorful kites, try delicious bites from the local food scenes, and enjoy pet-friendly activities. If you'd like to enjoy a beautiful day outdoors, you can find more information about this at So, what do you guys think?
I want to head to the Kite Festival. I see everyone on Instagram, and I was like, oh, I wish I could go. So now that I know when it is, I'm excited.
Is it going to be windy this weekend? Like, will the kites fly?
It's been windy lately. That I couldn't even walk in the parking lot the other day.
Yeah, today was bad.
I mean, it'd be like a good date idea for like the two of you. You know, like go out flying kites and everything.
Yeah. Anyways.
Well,
thanks, Reagan. We'll be back with this Friday Sports Report right after this break.
Come audition for Cedar Park Tonight talent show.
You can find the link in the class of your graduating year Google Classroom.
Audition.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I'm Michael Strahan. You're watching the Wolfcast, and I'm being forced to do this in the cold.
Yeah! Welcome back to the Wolfcast Sports Report. I'm Katie Whitmarsh.
And I'm Risa Elizondo.
Starting off with track and field, in just a few hours, those who qualified for the 95th annual Texas Relays race will be heading down to UT's track to get ready for some big races. Congrats and good luck to all of our athletes.
To stay updated with all the races Cedar Park is running in, make sure you head over to our Instagram and Twitter at CPHS News.
Moving over to baseball and softball, both teams have a home game tonight at 7 o'clock. Softball is against Liberty Hill and baseball against Lockhart. Good luck, everybody.
Finally, after the boys' soccer team impressive playoff win against Alamo Heights in a sudden death penalty kick match that ultimately put CP in the lead 2-1, tonight the boys will travel to San Marcos High School for round 3 against San Antonio Southwest. This is definitely going to be a big game, so make sure to come out and support the Wolves, and good luck to our boys' soccer team.
That's all we have for you today with CPHS News. I'm Katie Whitmarsh.
And I'm Risa Elizondo. Back to you all at the desk.
Thank you all for taking time to join us during your den. You can catch anything you missed and more on our Twitter or YouTube at CPHS News.
And don't forget to follow our dedicated sports Twitter at CPHS_sports for updates during the games. With CPHS News, I'm Jack Polishook.
And I'm Abby Martinez. Remember to make it a great day or not. The choice is yours. Have a great Friday, Cedar Park.